On American Idol, and David is here right now to talk to our good friend Jason Castro.
Yeah, Jason Castro really struggled this week after forgetting the lyrics to his song. Simon told him to pack his bags. Last night he was voted off the show, and Jason Castro joins us live from Los Angeles this morning. Jason, I got to ask you, did you follow Simon's advice and pack your bags on Tuesday night?
Well, actually, I was already planning on doing that. My mom brought an extra suitcase. Not because I was going home, but I had just been sending home luggage early because there was so much stuff I've gotten since I've been here.
Yeah, I bet.
So, I was packed up. It worked out.
Well, let me ask you. You've really been struggling the past couple of weeks. Did you know that this was coming? What was going on?
I mean, as soon as we started hitting two songs, like, that's kind of the part I feared all season long. And it was just too hard for me to keep up. I couldn't focus, and I didn't have enough time to connect with the songs. And so, I mean, it was only a matter of time. But
now, did you really tell Entertainment Weekly in an interview last week that you were ready to go home?
I do recall that interview. It was kind of one of those days I was frustrated with everything. And I got in that interview, and I just kind of... It's just one of those days, you know, there's ups and downs, but I did not want to go home.
So you did not, because everybody was feeling like you kind of had this attitude that you were ready to go. In fact, there's a website now, Mike found.
TMZ.com said that they're slowing down, the Ellen DeGeneres show is slowing down a tape that says, it looks like you're mouthing the words, don't vote for me.
Yeah, I've heard about that.
Is that true? What'd you say?
No, I was saying vote. Okay. I said it twice. I was excited. Trying to make it the top three.
That's funny. They're trying to cause some controversy.
I know. There's always controversy.
It's got to be. Can you give us an idea of how tough this is? I mean, it's like you go home a little bit earlier, you get some rest, but it seems like you guys are just in lockdown, American Idol 24/7. Is that what it's like?
It is. I mean, even now, I'm running off an hour of sleep and doing interviews all day.
Yeah, I can't imagine.
But it's been a wild ride for you, and I'm sure you got many more great things coming up. Hey, a lot of young girls were really... really liking your eyes and your hair. I thought you had the coolest hair.
Including this young girl right here sitting next to us.
Exactly. How long did it take you to grow out your hair?
Well, I haven't cut my hair in like 5 or 6 years now.
So cool.
And Jason, I got to ask you, I'm thinking about changing my look myself, so I'm thinking about growing out the dreads. What do I have to do? Do you really not cut your hair? I mean, wash your hair all that time?
Oh, no, I wash my hair. I mean, at first, you don't wash it too much. But now I wash it every day.
But how does it get to that point? What do you do?
Well, it was actually like a process. We kind of, like my mom did it, kind of like teasing, just knot up the hair and put wax in it and just let it lock up. It just tangles. That's all it is.
Well, I love good. It. I really do.
Well, it's good to know, Jason, you do get a little worked up every once in a while.
Yeah.
Seem pretty laid back. And good luck with everything.
Thank you.
Great to see
you. We'll see
you
in a few weeks at the finale. Thanks, Jason.
All right, people, that's the bad news. Let's shift to American Idol, shall we? You saw it last night if you're watching on Fox 25 morning, Fox 25, American Idol, Jason Castro, the latest to get the old boot. My man joins me there from L.A. Good morning, buddy. How are we doing this morning?
Good morning. We're doing good.
Let me tell you what. You, my friend, had one heck of a ride, and I bet you there's a lot of 12 and 13-year-old girls out there whose hearts are broken right now.
I'm sorry.
Listen, if nothing else, you were very, very unique in this competition. You brought your own thing to the table. Do you think that was part of the reason why you were able to survive so long?
Yeah, I think that's definitely, the reason I was here. Just because, I don't know, I guess nothing like me's ever been on the show. And man, it was fun.
Yeah, I bet it was. Did you have any idea going into it what to expect, because you had this attitude that was kind of like, I do this all the time, it's no big deal for me. I mean,
well, definitely I'd never done that before, but I had no expectations. I didn't know what it would be like, and from the beginning, I just had the mindset that, whatever happens, I wasn't worried about it, and it wasn't going to make or break me, so just had fun with it.
Did that help you keep your nerves down? It seemed like at least you were under control, at least especially when you were singing.
Yeah, I mean, I think so. It's all the same, singing there or singing at home. Once you're singing. And I don't know, I kind of never really thought about the audience out there, just the people in the house.
Sure. Hey, what happened Tuesday night? Did you have lunch with Brooke White prior? You forgot the words.
I know. Man, I just mentally, this day, just everything, my head's just been, I don't know, like, last night, it was such a relief to finally you know, no, I don't have to learn three songs next week. It was just too much. My mind couldn't keep up.
Do you think people have any clue of how intense it is and what you guys have to do behind the scenes? All they see is your performance,
yeah.
But there is so much more going on behind.
You have no idea. Like, it's a lot of stuff.
Okay, man. So what's next for you? Obviously, you got the tour, because, man, you were number four. I mean, you made it all the way to number four. I mean, so you got the tour. And hopefully after this, maybe a record deal. What's on tap for Jason Castro?
I mean, you know, now it's time to get back to the music. I can quit singing other people's songs and do my own stuff. So I'm real excited.
Now let me ask you, have you seen the Jason Castro dolls?
I actually have. I heard they're selling them on eBay.
Yeah, they got the dreads and everything. They're good.
It's pretty good.
Yeah.
Can't complain.
There you are. You're an American Idol. You got a doll made after you, and you're all-around great guy. Jason, we'll see you in a couple of weeks out there for the finale, and congratulations on the success
you,
that you had on the show. We'll see you, buddy.
Thanks.
Jason Castro,
bye.
Live from Los Angeles.
Let me explain. Now, Jason is a real American Idol contestant, not a major rock star just yet. So to help tell his story, we hired a major rock star. Ladies and gentlemen, Huey Lewis. Huey, come on out. Jason, congratulations on making the top four. You know, you always seem so mellow on the show, even when the judges were critiquing you.
Yeah, you know, I was never really a favorite of Simon and Randy, but Paul was always there to say something nice.
Paul is sweet but dense, and she makes no sense. She's such a doll, more confusion every night.
Now that you're off American Idol, what are you going to do with your spare time?
Well, I'm working on a few new projects and thinking about changing my look up a bit.
I want some new dreads. Gonna try a new do. One that won't maybe sweat too much or look like Whoopi on The View.
After sitting through all those weeks of criticism, how do you feel now about Simon Cowell?
Well, you know, I think Simon's the best at what he does.
Taking what he's given because he's bitching for a living.
All right, best of luck. Thanks for being here. Folks, I want to thank Jason Castro and Hugh Lewis. We're right back with YouTube and Jenna Fisher. Huey, take us to commercial, buddy. Thank you, man.